bugs, it's Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome. And to my returning subs, my growing extended beautiful family, just thank you so much for taking the time out for yourself, being able to see the things that are unseen, and being able to embrace the things that we weren't able to embrace before that we can clearly now see for the future. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste, love and blessings, love and light, and many blessings are definitely coming your way. And if you have been watching my videos for a while and have not already, please like and subscribe, even hit that notification bell so you know when your girl's about to upload her next video. Also, if you're comfortable enough, please drop me a line or two. I love a chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me. And even if it's about the positive feedback or the content of my video, or you're just up telling me about your empathic gift and how it impacted your life and heading you towards a positive direction. And if you feel like the videos just gave you good vibes or good information you would love to share with a loved one, family, or a friend, or even, you know, fellow empaths that are really going through some dark times right now, please, you know, go ahead and share. While you're at it, give me a thumbs up, like, and also share on your social media favorites wherever you see fit. And thank you once again for stopping by my channel and showing so much love and support. It's greatly appreciated, and I hope you're able to resonate with the content of the video. And the meditation music I'm listening to today, and I love Buddha because it has remove all mental blockages, subconscious negativity, and dissolve negative patterns, binaural beats. You know we need that in our life. I'm gonna show y'all with this Buddha. If you can see it, it's really beautiful. I love Buddha. It's just like he gives me so much, you know, peace of mind when I see any kind of images of him. And today my video is about Heyoka's refusing to have a good day no matter what comes at you. We need to do that, you know, because there'll be times, like, I know there'll be days that, you know, I'll say, you know what, I'm waking up and it's going to be a good day no matter what, and next thing you know, you'll hear darkness coming in, like, oh, we'll see, you know, either, you know, that there'll be somebody coming at you crazy, or, you know, somebody coming at you with attitude, or, you know, something's coming up, you're trying to find something in your house and, you know, you can't find it nowhere, or you're just, you know, it just puts you in a funk. It could be, you know, plans get canceled for a certain situation, or, you know, somebody's narcissism comes at you in the wrong way, and it's like, well, you know, it don't take much for us to get rubbed the wrong way anyway. But it's just like being determined. That takes a lot of strength to be determined on no matter what. When you can be able to shift your mental vibes, your empathic vibes, that's what I need to say. It's just basically trying to figure out, you know what, no matter what is being thrown at me, you know, just ask the heavens and gods, you know, like, can you please get me through this day? You have to be able to do that, because there's times I know I'm walking around here and it's just like, you know, the children can get on your nerves, or, you know, you can be stuck in a financial funk, or, you know, things are not going the way you planned it for that day. You know, there's always something thrown in our way, and no matter what, we always should see good within that day, because it's just like, lately I've been trying, like, when things come, you know, I can't agree with in my mind, I'm like, oh, I'm tired of going through this and this and this and that. I try to find everything that is positive that's going on in my life at that moment in time. Yeah, it might not be going the right way where I want it to go, but, you know, the world will test us. Universe will test us. It's like, you know, darkness will come and bring something to you to allow you to really get into that low density. Or, you know, universe will try to test you to see if, okay, if you say you're not going to have a bad day, let me allow this to happen and see what, how you'll, you know, how you'll respond to it. And sometimes we can be able to tell when we're being tested, because someone will come up and you'll be like, looking at the universe like, I know that was y'all bringing that towards my way, but you know what, all right. Because there's sometimes I'll see it and I'm just like, you know what, I know that was a test altogether, just to see how I'm gonna respond to it. And yeah, it might have pissed me off at that point in time right there, but I'm just like, you know what, I'm glad this happened now, or I'm glad I'm able to be proud of myself because I didn't react to it the way I might have reacted to it before. Because like I tell y'all all the time, you know, we've gone through different things on our journey where it's taught us valuable lessons and it taught us to raise our frequency, our vibes, just the way we look at things in a different perspective and see how sometimes, you know, when people see that your light shines bright, they will try to throw stuff in your way just because they want you. Misery loves company. People do that. Or people claim that they know you. I've had so many people telling me, oh, well, Roslynn, you need to do this, you need to do that. And I know what's going on in my head, but I don't need nobody trying to tell me, you know, if it's corrective criticism, I don't mind that. I love that. You know, if there's something I can correct, but it's just, I hate it when people think that they know me like that. I said, nobody knows me like that because I changed within 5 minutes at that time. And it's not to be fake, to more fake. It's just the fact is I learned so much. My frequency keeps going up and up and up. And I don't need nobody trying to sit up here and tell me I'm this way. I don't have enough confidence. I don't have enough strength. I hate that. It gets on my last nerve. But, you know, if it's somebody just trying to show me a different way to go about things, or, you know, find an easier way to do things, or just have to look at a different perspective, hey, I love that all day. But, and it's just like, I know I get tested that way. And sometimes I'm just like, whatever, you know, I'm gonna let you think what you want to think. But it's just when we can go about our ways in a more positive note and know things do happen. Things are not going to always go our way, and we're not going to always have a good day, you know, but we always have to try to find good within that day because it could be a lot worse. And I have to keep telling myself that, especially it was like a few weeks ago when my tire blew, and it was just like I just got my car out the shop, and it was just like I had to really be thankful. It was like I'm glad I was in the car by myself. I'm glad I didn't have my grandbaby with me or nobody in the car with me. You know, I'm glad the car didn't not flip over because the way that impacted that tire was, the way it blew like that, my truck could have flipped over, you know. So I was very grateful and blessed, you know. I was mad at that point in time, like, dog, is there anything else? And I had to stop myself, because you know when you can sit up here and say, can it get any worse? Yes, it can get worse, but you don't want to bring that type of energy towards your way. You have, when situations like that pop off, you have to be like, okay, this could have been the worst. You know, you could have flipped over in somebody's car. You might have, you know, hit somebody else's car and you didn't have insurance. Or, you know, some kind of jacked up stuff like that. You know, anything could have been worse, and you have to be grateful that it wasn't that bad. You know, and it's just like, okay, downside, you know, I get a piece. You know, I gotta drive nobody nowhere because I'm always a taxi cab driver. You know, but you being a mom, you always gotta go pick up, you know, your kids. Gotta run your kids. Gotta do this. Gotta do that. And so that's what kind of peace of mind I had to think about, you know. Try to find the goodness within every jacked up situation. You gotta always try to find the good in every jacked up situation. You might go through it with somebody, and you're like, dang, I've been, you know, I helped this person out. I was nice. I was letting them see things that they weren't able to see for themselves. I've had incidents like that. I had it recently that I was there for somebody when they were going through the most difficult things, put my feelings aside, put myself in a, you know, a certain situation where I was seeing things for them to help them get through their situation, even though it messed my emotions up, you know, because with you being an empath and being a medium at the same time and knowing you can see certain things when people pass away, and that's already messed up because with me, I get the emotions and the situation in my head, and that can really mess me up mentally. And when I was able to do that, knowing somebody was just like, you know, low-key hating on me and knowing that happened to me, you know, I said, you know what? I'm not even going to take away what I did for that person. It is what it is. But, you know, you just messed up a good friendship, not me. You know, I'm good, but I know I was there for valuable reasons. But when people can, you know, they'll use you for your benefit, but when you need somebody to talk to, they, you know, they're like blowing everything off. It's all good. You can, you know, let them people go, but they messed up. When they mess up a genuine relationship with you, don't even hate. You know, God and universe allow you to see what those people really were, what kind of intentions they had when they came into your life. So you should never get mad and say, you know what, I wish I never did this for that person. You wish it. That's when you show a character that does not even need to be, you need to even not even vibe towards. You know, be grateful that you were able to help that person. That shows a lot about your character. I don't wish bad things on people like that, because you know when push come to shove, especially when somebody's judgmental, because there's a lot of people that tell me, oh, you need to let go of your situation with your dad. I know I need to heal from that, but I try not to judge. I say you never want to judge somebody going in a situation like mine, because it's God, when you tend to judge people, God will easily put you in that situation for you to understand why that person is the way they did. It just so happened to happen that way with that person, that certain individual. And I was like, oh, you need to let go now. What'd you tell me? And I just sat there with my eyes just shifting like, oh, you know, you had to go through the same situation I did. And you had a whole bunch of questions. You had more questions than you had answers. So situations like that pop off with people. Don't worry about that, because that shows how much a good character you were, especially when you know you're a good friend towards somebody and somebody uses you in a way like that. Don't worry, because karma gonna get got anyway when it comes to people like that. You know, you just need to wish them well. I don't wish nothing bad on nobody, because I feel like whatever's gonna come to you is gonna come to you regardless on how I feel about the situation, especially if you know you're good with somebody. So allow yourself to have a good day, no matter if it has something to do with funky people that want to be fake towards you, or, you know, situations where you have to finally see the light. And it might be painful for you to be able to see it, but you're supposed to bless the universe for allowing them to reveal things to you, especially when it comes to people's, you know, hidden motives when it comes to stuff like that. Because I've been people's lights of light has been showing so much towards people. And I just got to see. You know what? Blessings to you and keep it moving. So I hope you're able to resonate with the content of this video. You know, if you're going through something right now, try to find the best in it. You know, try to have a good day, because, you know, you're worrying and stressing over things that you cannot change. It's not going to help your situation any better. It's just going to bring you in a worse situation. So it's just like when I think about the things I go through, I try to think about the good things. You know, yeah, I got my situation going on where I'm still trying to heal, but it allowed me to see things for what they truly are. It allowed me to see my strength, allow me to have my wisdom and knowing, you know, I can see the things that are happening and is playing out. And knowing I've been able to get wisdom and strength and knowing who I truly am and where do I fit in a certain situation that has brought me blessings. So I'm glad I went through a lot of things, because those experiences taught me a lot. You know, you really have to look at things like that, especially when it comes to something really bad like that. You lose people, you gain more people. You know, you see situations for what they are, you see people for the way they are. And you know, you send blessings towards anybody. If they do bad to you, send blessings. If they did good to you, send blessings to them. You know, and things will happen the way they're supposed to happen. So I hope you're able to resonate with the content of my video. Much love to you. I'm giving my post notification shout out to JD23 and Lauren Harrison and Greg Holzer. Much love to you. Many blessings. Now, as much love and light and positivity as you possibly can. Know that you are truly blessed, highly favored, and forever loved. And knowing there's always somebody out there praying for your better days. So I hope you have a blessed, safe weekend. Be responsible for everything you do. Send out as much love and light and positivity as you possibly can. Know that you are truly blessed, highly favored, forever loved. And knowing there's always somebody out there praying for your better days. I pray for y'all each and every day. And I love you from the bottom of my heart. And I'll see you later. Much love, peace, and be wild.